Alexander is kicked out. Behind his own net is Lonsbury, and now we have Alexander and DuPont glaring at each other, and neither one of them had dropped their sticks, Ted Lindsay.
Now we've got Garland putting up airlock on the top of Mel Bridgman's head, and now Bill wants to drop his gloves, but nothing's going to come of that as Ron Finn has the back of Bridgman's shirt, and they're holding Garland apart. Claude Bichard has the leap winger. 7-4 here with 7:39 left. Darryl Sittler with 5 goals, and Ted, they've just added a goal, an assist on that first goal in this period by Sittler to Turnbull. He now has 4 assists, which is just one shy of points by a defenseman in a playoff game.
Well, how do you...
All right, let's go to tell you that with 7:39 remaining in the third period, 7-4 Toronto. Here at Toronto, it has been a nightmare for the Flyers as they trail 7-4. Now DuPont's going in along with Bridgman. Alexander's going in with Garland, so there are 2 men in the box for each team. And we're going to have to pick up. That will make the penalties 14 for the Flyers, 14 for the Leafs. Flyers have already set a series playoff record for penalties and penalty minutes. And they're all going to be minors, so the teams will play the next 2 minutes, each with 3 skaters, which would give Sittler a marvelous opportunity to bang for number 6. The only other player who's ever scored more than 3 against the Flyers in their 9 years was Berenson on November 8, 1968, when he got the 6 at Philadelphia.